Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how I can build a simple and expandable serial to parallel converter you can see on the right side that can be used either in combination with a parallel to serial converter to build a redstone equivalent of a physical layer of a USB connection, or in itself it can be used as a triggered pulse form analyzer or signal sampler. And well, basically, this thing here works by getting triggered, and 5 ticks after it was triggered, it starts sampling the single input line here and putting the corresponding information 1 tick after the other onto the various outputs here. So each of those lamps here represents 1 tick of the input signal. In this case, I have input this via this parallel to serial converter here. So as you can see, I have changed input and now the outputs here have also changed correspondingly. So this is what this thing here does essentially. And with that out of the way, let's talk about the size. As you can see, it's 6 blocks wide. I'm not counting the lamps here since they are only representing the outputs but not part of the actual circuit. Then it's a total of 6 blocks high. 7 blocks if you have more than 15 outputs due to the fact that redstone signals only travel 15 blocks. And the length is the number of outputs plus 2. So that's the size. Now let's talk about the required resources. So those are the resources for the serial to parallel converter. Of course you will need some building blocks. Then for the trigger mechanism you will need 1 slab, 1 redstone block, 11 redstone dust, 4 redstone repeaters, 2 normal pistons and 1 sticky piston. And for each output, so for each of those modules, you will need 3 redstone dust, 1 redstone torch, 2 repeaters and 2 sticky pistons. And for every other module, you will need additionally 1 redstone dust and 1 slab. This is simply due to the fact that it's an alternating design and one of those slices needs, or every other slice needs 1 slab and 1 redstone more than the others. And then for every 16 modules you will need 4 redstone repeaters and 2 slabs additionally. And that's basically all you're gonna need. So with that out of the way, let's quickly show you how to build this converter here. Okay, so for the serial to parallel converter I'm using my parallel to serial converter as an input. Then I have this little golden line here, which is our redstone connection. And then we have already built the actual input of the serial to parallel converter, so which is a simple redstone repeater running into a normal block. Then from there on, I will for now just build 2 modules, then the rest is just a copy-paste from this. So for this, let's start with a 2-wide platform with redstone at the back and 2 repeaters going towards the front. Make sure they are all on 1 tick. Then from there on go 4 blocks up and place a sticky piston facing downwards like that with a block to the face. Now if you power the sticky piston we should have the block right in front of the repeater. Then let's place a sticky piston there. So if we power the sticky piston up here, the repeater can power this sticky piston. Then block to the face of this, block below it, torch here, and finally a redstone torch here, lamp here. This represents just an output. If you want to use a redstone line for this, I would recommend putting in a repeater, then run this into a block and then have a double inverter. The reason is the converter here resets all outputs before it starts sampling the input. And while it's doing this, it will produce a very short positive pulse in here, since essentially what happens is it's extending this piston down here for a moment and then retracting it. And this will produce a very short output pulse, and if you don't want this in your output, you might want to add a few redstone torches here, which will ignore this very short pulse essentially. But for this example, I will just use a lamp there. So anyway, the second module looks exactly the same until this point here. Then let's put two blocks up there, a redstone line there. And finally, let's put another line of blocks up here, also with redstone on top. The reason for this will become obvious later on. So, then it gets to the parts that's not the same for the alternating designs. We start at the corner with the input, put the block right next to the first piston, then a block down here, repeat on two ticks in this direction, block up here, followed by an upside down slab there, redstone dust on top of the slab, and a repeater again on two ticks on top of the normal block, and that's the general layout, which now has to be repeated until you reach your wanted or needed amount of outputs. So once you've done this, it's time for a few little modifications. First, let's remove this last repeater here, which is going nowhere. Then, if you have more than 15 modules, you will have to modify the modules a bit. For this, power the redstone line of the first module. Then look for where the signal breaks off. Move the next redstone line, lower the block by one, put a repeater in here on one tick, redstone normal block on top, redstone on top, cut off that wire here. Then at the same module, replace this redstone line here, and on the module 2 before that, put a repeater in this direction. Then on the module before, remove this redstone repeater up there on the block. Then block here, repeater in this direction on two ticks, run this into a normal block, then block around the corner, redstone line on top. Remove this repeater down there and the block on top. Below it, I mean. Then grab a slab, place it here, remove this one here temporarily, and replace it with a slab there. Repeat on two ticks there, repeat on one tick there. Then raised block here, lowered block there. Repeat on two ticks in this direction, redstone on top of this block, and finally block in this corner. And we are done with this part. If you have still a part where the redstone signal breaks off, you will have to repeat this a few more times. And then, once you have done this, you can depower the entire thing. Next part is building the actual trigger mechanism. For an autumn trigger mechanism, let's quickly or simply put 5 blocks in an L shape like that. Put redstone dust on top, then a sticky piston, a normal piston down there. Put 2 additional blocks on this line, redstone on top, another non-sticky piston below there. Then normal block, followed by a redstone block. Then block here with redstone on top, sticky piston there, with a block on top, block here, repeater on two ticks there, this is the automatic reset. Then block there, repeater on two ticks in this direction, block to the front and on top, redstone on top, another 2 blocks like that, repeat on two ticks here, and another repeat on one tick there, and we have an automatic reset that expects a short pulse that starts 5 ticks before the actual information starts. If you don't want to use that way of triggering, you can actually remove this redstone line here and replace it with an automatic triggering line that triggers the mechanism here 5 ticks before the actual information starts. So now the last thing to place is actually a connection at the back here, so we have to connect this last module with this reset of the trigger mechanism, so let's quickly put a slab down there and a redstone on top, and with that we are actually finished. So if you look at the parallel to serial converter, you will see a little sequence here, in this case with 3 pulses, and once we trigger this through this redstone line here, we will see a short moment later the whole thing here will have the same sequence on this side, so it's actually working. So anyway, as you might have seen or can see right now, the reset here produces a very short positive pulse, which, as I already mentioned, can be filled out with a double negator. But anyway, that is essentially how you can build this expandable serial to parallel converter. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!